In this example, we are given that a thin wooden rod of mass m and length l is floating in water, and we are required to find force required in vertically upward direction to lift the rod from water surface. And in this situation, we also given that the surface tension of water is T. Say this is the container in which a rod is floating. I am just drawing the cross section of the rod. Its length perpendicular to the plane of the sheet is L. And it'll be experiencing its weight mg in downward direction. So if we wish to lift it by applying a force F, we can say the situation would be like this. If we'll have a tendency to lift, I am just slightly magnifying the situation, due to surface tension. The water particles will stick to the rod surface, will move along with this, and due to surface tension of force will be acting on both the edges of the rod in downward direction. And as the length of this edges is L and surface tension is given as T, we can say the force applied by the surface tension on the edge of the rod will be TL and TL on the two sides. So to lift it, we need to balance its weight and as well as the force due to surface tension. So in solution we can write, to lift the rod, we need to apply the force which is mg plus the total force of surface tension. Also we need to balance which is acting in downward direction in the rod will have a tendency to move up. The surface of liquid will be almost vertical when the rod is being lifted, so net force on it is 2TL. So this will be the answer to this problem. Quite a simple problem, but it is good to analyze and visualize the force of surface tension acting on the edges of the rod.